Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of MySQL on Windows operating system. So let's begin. Now to install the latest version of MySQL, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in that address bar you need to just simply search with MySQL download and hit enter, and you'll be getting this www.mysql.com as your first search result. And here you can see that this MySQL download option is there, so just simply click on this link and it will going to redirect you to this official site of MySQL. And here you need to just simply scroll down and you'll be getting this MySQL community GPL downloads. So just simply click on that and it will going to redirect to this MySQL community downloads. In here you need to just simply click on MySQL installer for Windows. So this will going to redirect to MySQL community downloads, and here you can see our latest version of MySQL is version 8.0.31, which is we're going to install. So you're going to download this product, which is 431.7 MB. So just simply click on this download button and you can see this link, no thanks, just start my download, and there you go, our download of MySQL is rightly started. Now since I have already downloaded it, I just simply cancel it and I just minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory and you can see my MySQL community edition 8.0.31 is rightly downloaded over here. To install, just simply double click on the product. So MySQL I community installer installation wizard is rightly open, and it will ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes, and let's minimize our download directory. And it will again ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes, and there you go, our MySQL installer 1.6 is rightly launched. So here is our product. So from here you need to just simply click on the custom installation, because I'd like to install only MySQL server, then MySQL shell and workbench. So workbench will be using for our GUI interface. So you need to just simply click on custom and then just simply click on next. And here you can see that we have MySQL server. So just simply click on this plus icon to expand it, and you'll be getting this MySQL server 8.0.31. So just simply select that and click on this arrow so that it get listed under product to be installed. Similarly, you need to do the same for our application. So just simply expand this and keep this workbench, MySQL workbench 8.0.31 under product to be installed. Similarly, let's do the same for MySQL shell as well. So just simply expand this and click on MySQL shell and drag it to the product to be installed. So MySQL server is like our main SQL server, and GUI interface, if you want to use our MySQL server in a graphic user interface, then you need to use workbench, or if you want to use in our command prompt, then you can use MySQL shell. Okay, so simply do this much and then just simply click on next, and you can see that under installation we have these three products which are ready to be installed. So just simply click on execute, and there you go, our installation has rightly began. So it will going to install our SQL server, then workbench and shell, and it will take some time, 3 to 4 minutes maybe. So I'll be coming back after finishing of this process. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that our all three products is rightly installed. So just simply click on next. So it's now time to configure our MySQL server. So just simply click on next. And here under type and network, you can see that it has already checked this TCP IP protocol, which is totally fine. And this is our port number. So this port number is a very important number. So we generally use this port number to communicate with our front end application with the back end. So there we need to provide a port number, then password. So this port number is quite important. Okay. And all other things are totally fine, so you can keep everything as default and click on next. And here under authentication method, it is already checked this radio button to use strong password. So for authentication, totally fine, just simply click on next. And here you need to give that password, so let's give the password. Okay, so this is just you are using in local system, so a weak password doesn't matter. Okay, and this will be the password for root user, Let's say you want to create a new user, you can always do that by just, you know, simply clicking on this add user button, and you can, you know, give your credentials for creation of the new user. Okay, so for now, in this video, I'll show you for the root user. So just simply click on next after that, and this is going to be our, you know, Windows service name. So it will automatically, you know, install our Windows service and automatically going to start that. Okay, so you don't need to do anything. So just simply click on next. So here it's asking for file permission, so just simply grant that, not a problem. Just simply click on next, and here we are going to, you know, apply all the configurations. So just simply click on execute, and there you go, it has, you know, rightly started to configure. So right now it is, you know, initializing our database, so it is clearly telling that it might take some time. So, you know, I'll be again pausing the video and I'll be coming back after, you know, we have configured everything. Yeah, so welcome back, and now you can clearly see that it is, you know, rightly configured. So just simply click on finish. So, you know, our configuration is complete. Just simply click on next, and now it is, you know, checked to a couple of checkbox, like whether you like to, you know, start MySQL Workbench and MySQL Sale as well after setup. So I'll just simply, you know, launch the Workbench. Okay, so just simply click on finish, and it will going to start launching our Workbench. But before that, we need to do one very important step. Go to, you know, our C drive, then program files, and you'll be getting MySQL folder that you created over here. So just simply go inside that folder, and you need to go inside MySQL server, and then you'll be getting this bin folder, and here you need to just, you know, simply click on this address bar, then right click and copy. Okay, and now just simply click on this magnify icon and just simply type over here environ. Okay, and it will going to show you this edit the system environment variables. So just simply click on that, and it will going to open our system properties window. So here you need to just simply click on environment variables, and you'll be getting this window. So here under system variables, you need to click on path, and now you need to click on edit, and then new, and then right click on it and paste. That's it basically. Now just simply click on OK, then again OK, and then again OK. Okay, now just simply minimize it, and see our MySQL Workbench is rightly installed. So you can click on this, you know, root user, and you need to give that password, and just simply click on OK. So you can see our query window rightly open. So you can easily, you know, type this command. So I'll just simply run one by one this SQL command. So if you just simply click on, you know, execute these show databases, you can see that we have this many databases right now, which is a system performance schema and all. So let's create a new database called office record. So just simply execute the same, and you can see that, you know, it has rightly executed. So a new database created. So if we execute the previous command now, you can see that our, you know, office record is rightly created over here. So let's create a table inside our database called office records. So you can see a new table rightly created. So let's you know, insert you know, column record over there. So it is also inserted properly. So if you just simply execute this, you know, select start from office record.emp, you can see that record, the office record which is inserted, is rightly shown over here. Okay, so in this way you can easily install the latest version of MySQL on a Windows operating system. So that's basically all about this video. I have lately shown you how to install MySQL, then MySQL shell, and also MySQL Workbench. And after that, I have also set the environment path. That's a very important step, remember. And after that, you can, you know, easily start working in your Workbench. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.